The following presentation is brought to you by Discovery Education, leading the world of digital and video learning. Discovery Education, connect to a world of learning.
If you like helping animals and solving problems too, come and be mathematical and join the number crew. Join Fizz and Flo and Bradley and Ted and Mirabelle. And there's Baby Bunting who likes to help as well. So come and be mathematical and join the number crew. All aboard when you hear us call, the number crew needs you.
The good ship Mathematical. The number crew really do like to give those passengers a good time, don't they? Like that time that they built the roller coaster. The trouble was, the number crew tried to give too many passengers a ride at the same time. There was far too much for Fizz's wheelchair to pull along. That's the problem with having fun. It can all go wrong.
Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear.
Dad, you will be able to mend it, won't you?
Yeah, I think so.
Because the passengers do love their roller coaster rides.
Why is it broken anyway?
The motor's getting too hot. You've been trying to pull too much stuff along.
There's a lot of stuff in this elephant.
He's massive!
Exactly. We've got a lot of mass.
Mass. Do you know the word? The number crew have got to learn it. Mass means how much there is of something. Now, the elephant is big and bulky. Or, as Ted would say,
a massive thing like him has got plenty of mass.
Mass. Mass. He's got so much mass. As far as his mass goes, he's top of the class. If there is one thing he certainly has, it's masses and masses and masses of mass.
I think that'll do it. But if you try and pull too much stuff...
Too much mass!
It'll break again.
Oh, you're not going to stop Mr. Elephant riding on the roller coaster, are you?
Well, I think pulling just him along will be okay.
I'll give it a try. See? It's fine.
Yeah, I think it'll be all right. But that's the limit. Don't try pulling any more mass than this elephant.
Okay, one passenger at a time.
That won't be so much fun for the passengers.
Better than breaking down again.
If we can pull the elephant, we can pull any of the passengers. He must be the heaviest.
We'd better check, though.
How can we do that?
I don't know.
Have you thought of using a seesaw?
A seesaw? Has Ted gone bonkers? How can you use a seesaw to check whether something's heavier than something else? Maybe like this. Look. If I put something light on one end and something heavy on the other, which end do you think will go down? Let's have a look. Yeah, look, the heavier end goes down, doesn't it? And that's how the number crew can compare the passengers to see if any of them are heavier than the elephant.
Oh!
Weigh,
oh.
Weigh, they've got to be weighed. Who will be heavier? Which one would you say? If they're on a seesaw, who goes up or down? The one with most mass goes down to the ground.
So, the number crew got on with checking that none of the passengers was heavier than the elephant, that none of them had more mass. And once the passengers had been checked, they could go off and ride the roller coaster. Whee! Trouble was, checking all the passengers against the elephant was taking rather a long time, and the poor old elephant had to stand around on the seesaw all day long.
How many more passengers have we got to check?
I've got a whole list here.
Mr. Elephant's getting very bored.
But we need him here to check against the other passengers.
If only there was some way we could manage without him.
So, is there any way that we can give the elephant some time off? Is there another way that the passengers can be checked against the elephant without the elephant having to be there? And what we need, instead of the elephant, is something that weighs the same. Yeah. If we could find something that weighs exactly the same as the elephant... Hang on. How about that? Look. Can you see? Neither side goes up, neither side goes down. They weigh the same, don't they? They balance. So this pile of blocks weighs exactly the same as the elephant. Ah.
Okay, nearly there.
One more.
Block number 10 coming up. It balances. So the elephant weighs the same as 10 blocks. And now the elephant can have a rest.
Hooray!
And we can weigh the other passengers against the blocks.
Mr. Rhino weighs less than 10 blocks.
So he weighs less than the elephant. And he can go on the roller coaster.
It would be so nice if he had a friend to ride with.
Wait your turn, please.
No, look! The plank isn't going down.
So?
So that means the rhino and the kangaroo together aren't as heavy as the elephant.
Me.
And the penguin too.
These three passengers together aren't as heavy as the elephant. So they can all ride.
Hooray!
So the number crew weighed the passengers in groups. And as long as a group of them didn't weigh more than 10 blocks, they could ride the roller coaster together. They had lots of fun, and they didn't strain the motor, all because the number crew had learned how to weigh things. How much things weigh is very important. Lots of food is sold by how much it weighs, like fruit. And sweets. Why don't you try to find out how much things weigh? How many toy blocks do your toys weigh?
It balances.
How many marbles weigh the same as a soccer ball?
Kilograms.
How many children weigh the same as a teacher? And who is heavier? Baby Bunting or the elephant?
Join Fizz and Flo and Bradley and Ted and Mirabelle. There's Baby Bunting who likes to help as well. So come and be mathematical and join the number crew. All aboard when you hear us call, the number crew needs